Hello, my name is Sami Ramzi Laibanura from the Martinique Clinic Prostate Cancer Center in Hamburg, Germany. We thank BGUI for the special opportunity to present our study entitled Open and Robot-Assisted Prostatectomy in Men Receiving Ongoing Low-Dose Aspirin Medication. Special thanks goes to my colleague and co-author Dr. Jens Hansen, the other co-authors, and particularly Dr. Lars Bodeus, the initiator of the study. Due to their age, prostate cancer patients were often diagnosed with coronary artery disease and consequently have received coronary stenting. For the majority, lifelong aspirin intake with 100 mg per day is recommended. There is data suggesting that aspirin intake may lead to a higher rate of bleeding complications in surgically treated prostate cancer patients. This places the surgeon in the dilemma to decide whether or not to continue aspirin medication perioperatively. We hypothesize that open and robot-assisted prostatectomy is feasible in patients with ongoing aspirin medication without greater blood loss. Thus, we assessed blood loss, transfusion rates, and 90-day complication rates in 2,061 open and 400 robot-assisted prostatectomy patients. Aspirin intake during surgery was recorded in 137 patients. Descriptive statistics and multivariable analysis after propensity score matching was used to assess blood loss above the median in both operation groups. Propensity score matching was used to balance for potential differences between patients with and without aspirin medication. As you can see in this table, the median blood loss in the open radical prostatectomy cohort with and without aspirin medication was 750 and 700 milliliter, respectively. And in the robotic-assisted prostatectomy cohort, it was 200 and 150 milliliter, respectively. There was no significant difference. Within the same cohorts, transfusions were administered in 21 and 8% and 0 and 1% of patients, respectively. This table shows that the 90-day complication rates in patients with ongoing aspirin medication were 5.8, 4.4, and 7.3 for cleaving grades 1, 2, and 3, respectively. No patient experienced a grade 4 cleaving complication. As you can see here in multivariable analysis and after propensity score matching, prostate volume, but not ongoing aspirin medication, achieved independent predictor status for the risk of blood loss above the median. Moreover, surgical volume reached independent predictor status. We concluded that major surgery, such as open radical and robot-assisted radical prostatectomy, may be safely performed in patients with ongoing aspirin medication. Moreover, we did not detect a higher 90-day complication rate in such patients. Differences in transfusion rates between patients with and without aspirin medication may be explained by a higher proportion of coronary artery disease in patients with ongoing aspirin medication. Thank you for your attention.